God of vast and diverse creation, today we celebrate pride, the gift of living into the fullness of who you have created us to be. Bless all who celebrate this day with joy in the knowledge that they belong. We come with gratitude, Holy Mystery, for all the ways you are known to us, and for all the ways you confound our comprehension. We give thanks to you, O God, both Mother and Father, and still between and beyond all our categories of understanding. We celebrate your Spirit among us that beckons us out to new horizons of hope, fuller communion with your being and to the fullness of our own being. We give thanks for all the ways that love finds us. As we celebrate, keep within us the memory that pride is also protest, a prophetic witness to the struggle of lesbian, gay, bisexual, trans, queer, intersex, asexual, and every non-conforming ancestor who has gone before us. We remember today that the joy and love we express are courageous acts of sacred resistance, testament to the goodness of your creation, a celebration of triumph over the forces of dehumanization and shame. With gratitude, we call to mind the faces of all the holy trailblazers in our own lives and in our larger story, who fought and suffered much, who modeled wisdom and compassion to show us how wide and inclusive love's welcome is. We hold these people in our hearts. Bless and keep also the saints among us now, those still using their gifts to speak out in myriad ways and showing us the continuing revelation of your kingdom of love. This morning we remember especially those for whom living authentically has meant loss and grief. We remember those struggling to come out to themselves or their loved ones. We remember those who have been cast aside by family and friends, those abused and silenced, and all lives cut short by shame, stigma, and prejudice. Forgive us, O God, when we let fear shrink our hearts and we try to place limits on your boundless love. May we keep striving to make a world where all people know dignity and can enjoy a life of love and health and equal rights. We pray that this remembering will strengthen our commitment to create sanctuary and deep welcome for those who have been marginalized. May our worship increase our awareness of grace, that we might give and receive it more freely with one another and all those we encounter. And may our worship reveal the work that is ours to do. O God, turning now to our own faith community, we pray for any within our congregation are known to us who are struggling in body, mind, or spirit. Those who are ill. We think particularly today of Ken Alexander, Karen Hoschel's brother, who is ill. For those grieving or lonely. Those who are confused, fearful, facing difficult decisions or challenging changes. Those awaiting or recovering from surgery or aggressive medical care. Those who face discrimination or prejudice of any kind. Those who find faith in you a challenge and have difficulty sensing your indwelling presence of comfort and strength. Lord, soon we will leave the sanctuary and return to our everyday world. As we do so, open us to the wind of your Spirit, felt but uncontrollable, trusted but undefinable, around us and within us as our very breath. We release ourselves to your Spirit, to your love, to your grace, and pray that we might be witnesses of your Spirit, agents of your love, and instruments of your grace, now and in the days to come. We pray all this and all of our unspoken prayers through Jesus, who taught us this prayer. We now say aloud and together. Our Father, our Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
Rabbi Klusmeyer, and the words channeled, I believe he was the same lyricist who wrote the words for Sweetwater, the one we sang last week, Sweetgrass and Camel.
Oh, right. Yes, you're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. Which is, it advocates for LGBTQ youth, working with communities to make sure that they have shelters and their youth centers are inclusive. And it's organized around Washington, D.C., where this center is. So this is the song True Colors.